Welcome to Down to the River with Pastor Adam from Oglesby Union Church. Down to the River is a fast 5 minutes to drink in some of the living water given to us by Jesus through studying His Word, the Bible. From Oglesby Union Church, here's Pastor Adam.
I remember eating ribs, dripping with barbecue sauce and plenty of napkins. Now, the Bible introduces us to ribs in the first book, Genesis, as it says in chapter 2, verse 18, "Then the Lord God said, 'It's not good for man to be alone. I will make a helper corresponding to him.'" Well, God's going to make one more creation. A few verses later, he tells us how he does it. It says, "The man gave names to all the livestock, to the birds of the sky, and every wild animal. But for the man, no helper was found corresponding to him. So the Lord God caused a deep sleep to come over the man, and he slept. And God took one of his ribs and closed the flesh at that place. And then the Lord God made the rib he had taken from the man into a woman and brought her to man." Now, when we say the phrase spare rib, we might put the emphasis on the spare part of it, like it's just an extra, or an afterthought, or not necessary. So you could assume that the Bible thinks of women as just an extra, an afterthought, and not necessary, but that would be a false assumption. The Bible gives us the whole picture of our world, the good, the bad, and the ugly, and it doesn't hide injustice from its pages, but rather it exposes it to see the correct path. The reference of Eve, the first woman, being a helper corresponding to Adam might seem like a subordinate position, but the Hebrew word for helper to describe the woman is also the word used to describe God. God is my helper. Same word. Jump to the New Testament and Jesus makes himself known in his risen state to who first? The women at the graveside. He even uses women to be the heroes of the sum of his events in his life. Women are highly valued in the sight of God and Jesus in the pages of the Bible. So this helper corresponding to Adam, the first man, was taken from his side where his ribs are. She wasn't formed by God from man's head to rule over him or from his feet to walk over her, but from his side to walk along with. But let me take this picture of creation one step farther, or maybe a wider angle, to see another story unfolding here with the creation of the woman, the bride for Adam. For his first words to her were, "This one at last is bone of my bone and flesh of my flesh. This one will be called woman, for she was taken from man." I want you to think of another man who was put into a deep sleep, actually death, and also had his side pierced, cut into. He hung on a cross for the forgiveness of the sins of his bride, the church, and the church was created because of that event. Just as Adam and Eve awoke from surgery to be brought together, so Jesus and his bride, the church, will be brought together someday to live forever together. And the church exists because Jesus exists. It was created through him, and we use that phrase when someone is saved. He is in Christ. So we have this beautiful picture of Christ and his church in the creation of the first woman, Eve, and there's nothing demeaning about that. We have our men's monthly breakfast coming up on Saturday, March 24th at 7:30 a.m. We are worshiping with the Grace Bible Fellowship Church of Peru on Good Friday, March 30th at 6:30 p.m. And we are getting ready for Easter Sunday with a breakfast at 8 a.m. and an extended worship service starting at 9:45 a.m. on Sunday, April 1st. Plan to join us. I'm Pastor Adam, and thanks for listening this morning. Check out our website at ouc.life, and may you receive the blessings of God as you live your life to the glory of Him.
Join Pastor Adam this morning at Oglesby Union Church. They're right next to City Hall on Walnut Street, and their Sunday morning worship service starts at 10:15. Oglesby Union Church's mission is to know Jesus, grow in Him, go where He leads, and show His love. Drink more of the living water from Jesus today at Oglesby Union Church, and go down to the river again next Sunday morning at 8:25 on Classic Hits 103.9 WLPL.